Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Are you seeing under eye bags, fine lines, crepiness? Is your eye aging you first? Here's a video I'm going to show you with all natural under eye fix. See how you like it. We'll give you several solutions and Raj's recommendation. Now remember, if you like the video, click down here and subscribe, and you'll join our family and be updated on all the latest videos we post weekly to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant. Today, it's the under eye. Of course, it's the first area to age us all because it's thinner skin. And with thinner skin, you see the fine lines and wrinkles. You can get darkness and dark circles under the eyes. And then the eye anatomy is complex. There is fat pads above, and there's fat pads below. And the fat pads can herniate through, giving an under eye baggy look, or there can be a hollow that develops between fat pads and the demarcating planes that keep them together. Now this can happen over time, so it happens as people age, but keep in mind there's a genetic factor and it can happen from youth. And it can always be present. Some people call it the tear trough. Some people say, well, anatomically, that's not fully correct. What is a tear trough? It's a line between the fat pads and the demarcation of the lower fat pads in the mid face. So some people call it a nasojugal groove or the lid cheek junction. Whatever you prefer to call it, everyone's anatomy is slightly different and they're going to need slightly different treatments. Now, I've done videos on the ultimate under eye solution and using platelet rich fibrin fillers. We've done videos on mesotoxin or sprinkling toxin with cannula needles, all sorts. But for many people, they want a natural fix. They don't want neuromodulators or Botox-like products such as Jeuveau, Disport, and Xeomin. And they don't want to have fillers. Some people, of course, know that we have temporary fillers, hyaluronic acids. Permanent fillers, in my opinion, should never be used underneath the eye. Part of what makes this so complex, and when I've done talks and lectures lately on the brow lift, we go through the complexities of it, but it's the bone and the changes in the bone. One thing also keep in mind, we talk about fat pads, also the angle of the eye or the canthal tilt. A lot of people, to create beauty, want that upturned eye of about 4 degrees or so. And the bone changes to fight this. So the best way to think of aging bone is it melts. And by that, I mean you get hollows lower down and the eye socket rotates the wrong way for youth. Youth in the eye socket is flat to turned up, so you get that cat eye look. And a lot of people do their makeup to get that beautiful upturned eye. Some people have it, of course, naturally without makeup, and some people have it straight, but the bone nevertheless will tilt the wrong way in the aging eye. So when we talk about the under eye and the creating a youthful under eye, it's so complex because of the fat pads. And my personal strategy is to, when I'm lifting the eye, to think about recreating the bony loss, because really that's one of the hardest things to recreate or tilt. And to do that, you need to address the temple. And it's a whole nother video on injecting the temple and neuromodulators. I'll put these in the description below, because by affecting the muscles that turn down the eye, you can lift the angle up. But today, more importantly, is the all-natural fix. So the first part of an all-natural fix without any injections at all that I like to use is radio frequency or RF energy. The things to look for if you're going to do this, and by the way, when you travel the world, go to all kinds of different countries, specifically Asia, people are doing this all day, every day. They take care of their skin with all kinds of treatments and electronic devices and LEDs and home treatments. So we're behind on this in North America and Canada, in the USA particularly, but by using radio frequency, we can build collagen, we can make the skin better, we can create a lifting effect, and in a sense, there's no injections, of course, needed, and you can see it here. There's two electrodes, and the energy passes between the two electrodes. What do you want to look for? This particular device you're seeing is a Viora device, and why it's particularly good for the eye and the all-natural eye fix is because it's bipolar radio frequency. That means that the energy is going between the electrodes, and as it does, we can affect a couple things. Number one, if it's unipolar, the energy has to then drain somewhere, and a lot of those systems you'll see a pad on the back or somewhere for the energy to go to, because it needs to jump to another location. In this case, it jumps to the other electrode, so it's perfect. And when it does that, the other thing we can affect is, so we're not getting energy deep, but what we can then do is, by changing the frequency, we can ensure that it's strong energy but superficial. And that's what allows us to do the Plump RF and the Lip Plump, or the Plasma Lip, combine it with Plasma Lip, because just like in the lip, the eye and the forehead, we do not want to lose precious fat. Fat is youth in the face, and particularly the lip, around the eye and the forehead, we don't have a lot of it. And the most dangerous place to use filler is going to be not particularly around the eye or the temple statistically, but it is the medial eye, the forehead, the nasal area, and the nasolabial folds. So the eye certainly possesses its dangers as you go medially towards the angular vessel system, and the lower face is perfused by the external jugular, the upper by the internal. And the whole risk here, what we're talking about, is retrograde flow of filler or product that can create blindness or necrosis. And I've done a whole video on complications of dermal filler. You can watch that one as well. So by using radio frequency, we get energy, we build collagen, we create lift, we don't inject. It has to be the right type, and the bipolar, superficial, and a device that's very tunable allows you to do it. You will hear and you will see online people that have had high frequency ultrasound and RF energy devices, and particularly there was an eye tip of one of them years ago, probably around 2009-11 that I remember, and I had it, and it was getting rid of fat. And I think the fat was leaking. It would come back over time, but it took months and months. And that's what RF energy does if it goes too deep, which is why when you look at the video on the downturned mouth, we're using RF energy, but we're using it at a deeper layer to get rid of the fat we don't want at the downturned mouth. We don't want that in the eye. So that's an all-natural way to do it. That's the first step. And that's using radio frequency energy is my choice. Now, One side note on this, I'm going to tell you about the second part of this procedure, but keep in mind you can use RF energy also to rejuvenate around the eye in a fractionated form. And that's exciting because, again, the energy doesn't go through the body, it's superficial. And I've done this treatment, it's one of my favorites, I have to say, because it resurfaces, you can treat all skin types, but you get glow. So with the RF energy, the bipolar that I showed you just prior, that's going to give you tightening collagen formation. The fractionated version is going to resurface. It's not particularly great at getting browns. It will, but more so it's overall glow, skin tightening, and rejuvenation of the eye. So you can combine those two types of RF energy, the bipolar, the fractionated, if you want to, and that's all natural, no injections there. Although in a sense, in the fractionated, you're injecting energy, but most people will accept injecting energy. So what do we go to the second part? All natural eye rejuvenation, platelet rich, fibrin, PRF, not PRP, PRF. Fibrin is the key part of this. This is when, and I'm going to, I'll put a link to the PRF videos, how to produce a PRF versus PRP. Put it all in the annotations below. You'll see it in the description. But what it will do is we inject it. This is where we take your blood, spin the blood down. There's no additives, no heparin, no sodium citrate, there's no plastic plug, And when we spin it down, it's a slow spin speed. So what do we want in that milieu? Well, there's nothing extraneous. There's nothing other than your own body's materials. But the slow spin speed allows for white blood cells. It allows for fibrin clot to form when we inject it. You see, the dentists use PEARUP and they drop it into the socket. If the orthopedist can use PEARUP because it's a clot. But in aesthetics, we need it to find a liquid. And people lose their minds trying to spin it properly to get a liquid, because in those tubes, when you spin it, one little irregularity and boom, it clots. And then people sit there, what do I do? You can microneedle the clot in. That is a good use of it. You can put it on top of fractionated RF. But why not inject it? So you get that liquid. You have about 17 minutes in liquid form. Inject it. I prefer to, the plane of injection isn't as important, but if there's a deep eye bag, consider going beneath the souf. If it's fine lines and wrinkles, consider going on top of it, more superficial. A cannula is key because, again, there's no heparin in this, which is what makes it work well. It forms that fibrin clot, which allows slow release of growth factors over a week. You get a slightly baggy eye because of that clot. But I recommend a micro cannula, 25 gauge or bigger, because there's no extraneous factors in there like blood thinners, it will form a clot and it's safer to avoid intravascular complications. None have ever been reported. I've never seen one or heard of one, but we'd rather not. Anything's possible. And this is all natural in the sense that yes, we're injecting it, but we're taking your own body's products and injecting it back. What's it going to help with? First of all, it works with the RF. You heat and do the RF first. You can do all this at the same time. Bipolar radio frequency, fractionated radio frequency, and then finish it off with platelet-rich fibrin on top so it will heal the fractionated RF and inject it. Now, what's it going to do? Slow release of growth factors. Remember the problem with skincare? Skincare works great. We love it. But getting it absorbing through the skin is always the problem. And that's where companies are working on. Same thing with immunizations through the skin. Same thing with that Hyopen that you're driving. A lot of times non-cross-linked HA in the lips to plump them at home. We're going to do a video on that. But trying to get product deep. By injecting this platelet-rich fibrin, we know we're at the layers we want. And what we see is a slight plumping of the fat layer. We see rejuvenation. I see about 50% of people who have dark circles from lymphatics seem to improve. So about half, that's a low ball figure, maybe 75%, but always under promise, over deliver. It works very well. People do this every year to two, and they might do a second one. If the trough is deep, if they have an under eye where there's a deep trough, you might need to add hyaluronic acid filler to get it perfect. The less filler we need to do, the better. Why? Hyaluronic acid draws water in. All HAs do, some more than others. And I've done many videos on the under eye and what fillers we use, different things. But if we don't have to put a hyaluronic acid filler, it's better. We know a few things about them now. They last years here, maybe even 7 to 10 years. They migrate here. And I know from my own patients over 20 years of doing this that the HA, the hyaluronic acid, can start off looking perfectly and it can migrate forward. Of course it can. There's a concentric muscle around the eye, the orbicularis oculi. So it's always moving. And even though you put it perfectly on the bone, it could come superficial within a week or months. Or I've seen it 3, 4, 5, 7, 8 years. And when it does, you often need to dissolve it. So for us now, before anyone gets under eye filler, as much as possible, we do PRF first, 1 to 2 times, 6 weeks apart, and then we do our filler. Filler should be typically deep on the bone, at least underneath the suborbicularis oculi fat pad or the souf. Whereas platelet-rich fibrin is amazing because we can also put it superficial and helps with fine lines. So there's so many ways to use it, but there you go. All natural under eye rejuvenation is very exciting what we can do now. Radio frequency, bipolar and fractionated, and then you have your PRF, baggy under eye for a few days, release the growth factors deep and superficial to tighten the eye. And then of course, people can simply use their sunscreen after that with vitamin C's, hyaluronic acid, skincare, antioxidants, wear your sunglasses, all those preventive things we should be doing. And should somebody want filler thereafter, then they can. But if they want an all natural way to do it, that's my preference. So join us over on Instagram too. There's a lot of discussions over there, just full of knowledge from practitioners around the world commenting on our Wisdom Wednesdays and all our topics on controversial fillers and complications and all kinds of things you can learn on Instagram. And also subscribe to this channel here, become part of our family. We have weekly helpful tips, whether you're in the industry, an esthetician, nurse, doctors, injecting. We all look forward to your comments here. This is how we learn. So comment below this video. What do you like? What don't you like? What do you want to see of upcoming videos? Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.